Bonjour et merci d'être curieux dans On ne vous demande pas d'y croire. Aujourd'hui, nous allons parler anglais avec mes deux invités. Il sera question du corps en tant qu'énergie acoustique. Et c'est Dominique Thomas qui a eu la gentillesse de vous traduire les propos de mes invités. Sheila et Rocco, bonjour.
Bonjour.
Et merci d'avoir accepté mon invitation.
Merci pour l'invitation.
Alors, vous parcourez le monde donc pour des conférences, des formations. Mais avant de passer à la partie concrète de vos pratiques, parlez-moi de vous et de votre parcours qui vous a mené à cette approche si particulière des soins énergétiques.
Thank you so much for the invitation. It's a really interesting because we are like certified facilitators of Access Consciousness, which is a worldwide method. And the method itself is really different from other methods because the founders say that you are free to dig deeper in certain areas that you have a sense of different possibilities. There is one special area, which is the acoustical vibration, which is that's the nature of the infinite being that we are. And the whole thing started from a question. And in this method, you can like ask a question and play with the energy that comes up. And suddenly I had a sense that this is the topic, this is the area where I would like to find something else or dig deeper, and started to ask information about like, what is this, what is the acoustical vibration. So in Access Consciousness, it's about you choose something and by your choice, the energy comes to the surface. And like I was in the question, like, what is the acoustical vibration, for 3 weeks in a row, every day, and running an energetic body process with this question, and a totally different sensation and a different energy started to show up. And interestingly, new topics started to come, like as a download. And these topics were supporting the topic itself of what is the acoustical vibration and the infinite being. And it started to grow from there. And the first, let's say, breakthrough or big change was when we started to play with the milk. Because, you know, everything has an acoustical vibration that gives a structure and how it functions in this physical reality. And we were away from home for a week, and when we returned back, I wanted to drink a coffee with milk. So what happened that, because we were away for 1 week, the milk went wrong, it becomes sour. I started to receive information what I should do with this to change it. Because when you have a point of view, that point of view creates the reality in physical level as well. And my point of view was, this milk is expired because we left it in the fridge for 10 days. Of course it was sour, the smell was terrible. So it's not just a point of view, it's a physical reality. So I was holding in my hands that bottle of milk and I started to clear my points of view about that. And also I had a sense that there is an acoustical vibration for the good milk that is sweet, that is fresh. And I started to download that vibration into that bottle of milk. And like I had a sense that lots of energy is running through and there is some change happening there. So the process took like 5 minutes, and then let's taste it. And interestingly, the smell disappeared and the taste was good, it was sweet. So I put it back to the fridge. And I checked it 3 days later, and then again it was sour and it smelled bad. But I repeated the process and again it was good. So I did this in every 3-4 days for 2 weeks, and then I realized I have another point of view that I have to keep it in the fridge. You know, if it's possible, I can keep it on the kitchen bench and it will work there. So I placed it there for the next 2 weeks, and every 3 days I was playing with it, like changing back. And after 2 weeks I had a sense, like I had an idea, maybe there is something wrong with this, maybe, you know, something very special. So I bought another bottle of milk, a brand new, that was good, and I placed it on the kitchen bench just next to it. And so I decided, okay, I will do the process only to this one, but nothing to the other one. What happens then? So, and what showed up like 3-4 days later, that brand new milk, it was like full of green, red, and purple spots. So it was responding to the usual how things happening in this reality. So the two realities that you can choose which one works for you can stand next to each other. I wanted to see that, can we have two different realities like next to each other?
C'est une expérience de physique quantique.
Yes. And it's amazing. You choose your reality. And since then, we were playing with a lot of things and with bodies a lot. And one of the big thing about this acoustical vibration is the miraculous healing, how you heal the body. And so we were asking from the universe to show me more, what is this, how this works, that miraculous healing, what does it mean? And the universe has a very funny sense of humor. It didn't tell me anything, just started to send people with different diseases. And the amazing thing was, like, healing showed up within minutes.
Quel genre de maladie?
I start to tell the stories. There are so many stories we have.
Just one?
Just one.
Okay. Une.
One of the... Like, there was a person who had frozen shoulders. Mm. Like, his story was that he was working in a factory and he had to lift like 300 heavy boxes up to the top shelf. And because of that, these muscles started, like, became very frozen, and he went to the doctors and they said, we have to cut through everything and make a surgery, but maybe it won't work. Like, he'd been to massage and different things, but nothing ever happened.
Yeah, and he didn't want the operation, of course.
And then, so one of the things is that, who does this belong to? This is one of the topics, one of the key clearings in excess. So he had a story that he has this thing because of lifting the boxes. But it's always just a story, and the reality, like the truth behind it, is different. Because the person's point of view can maintain something or trigger something. So there was a lady, and so I was holding the hand of the man and then placed the lady's hand on it. Okay. Give it to her. So there is a space of this acoustical vibration, which is a space of infinite possibilities.
Mais est-ce que c'est de l'intention ou c'est par le son?
It has not much to do with the sound, but anyone can sense it, and people can sense it differently. Someone can see it, somebody can sense it on their skin, someone says there is a taste of it or smell of it. When we are talking about the sound part of it, the sound part is the one that helps the physical reality to move into the structure. Because it's not just the sound, but there is, behind the sound, there is an information. Actually, the sound is just one level of how the information can show up for us. Actually, the whole thing is about information that the human body and everything around us has the capacity to respond to information. For the physical body, sometimes the sound is the thing that can help the body to change, but it's not the only way how the acoustical vibration shows up. So what happened with this man, suddenly he had no pain, nothing, and he was able to move his arm in all directions, and he was just shocked. What happened to me?
Instantly,
yeah, that was it.
1 minute.
But the lady started to have the awareness of what was the root cause. The lady didn't have the symptoms. She had the information, what was causing the symptom for the man. So she had a vision that there was, you know, the two towers in 2000, 9/11, mm-hmm. and a lot of people were dying. Then suddenly the man said, oh my God, when this happened, he was watching it, the TV, and he made like a 4-hour meditation as an offering for the people to help them. And actually this was the origin of his problem that was triggering. Though it has nothing to do with the story, like the boxes.
Non, il n'était pas dans les deux tours.
No, he just watched the TV, and this whole thing happened like 15 years later. It was a memory, and for some reason it was triggered. So actually what we did, we separated the triggering memory from the body. Because what happens that you can place an information in the body, and that information creates a vibration that creates a limitation. And we can have diseases or symptoms that has nothing to do with actual situations. Like there was a lady who had been stung by a bee and she had an allergic reaction and her right arm just swollen up to the double size. Jesus. And she was unable to use her arm, it was painful. And for her it takes like more than 1 week for that to heal. So what happened, I asked, okay, would you need some help or change with this? She said yes. And then I was like checking where in the body or what is happening, what's there that keeps maintaining this hole. And what showed up, that there was like an implant in the body from a previous lifetime. And I removed the implant and immediately the pain disappeared.
Par hypnose?
Hypnosis?
No,
hypnosis, nothing like that.
Intention, par l'intention.
So there is an energetic body process that we created.
D'accord.
For this purpose.
Après, vous m'expliquerez comment concrètement vous faites ce soin énergétique.
So there are two things. There is the physical body and the infinite being. And the infinite being has infinite lifetimes, many, many bodies. So the body, what you have today, is just for this lifetime. It's brand new. But the infinite being makes things significant in previous lifetimes. And if there is something significant, it brings it to the next lifetime and implants into the body as a reminder. And when something happens, that reminder turns on, that is triggered, and it creates the change. And so you as an infinite being, you have the capacity to be present with anything. Connect to anything. Like as a mother, you can connect to your child and you know what's happening with your child. It's part of our reality, but it's not just for mothers and children. This is just the obvious part that we all agree. You can connect to anything, anyone, at any particular time. So actually we are working with information and energy, but energy is just a different form of information. So I connected to her and I received the information. This is an implant from a previous lifetime.
Vous lui avez pris la main?
Interesting part, I didn't touch the arm.
Comment vous recevez l'information?
So I was following the energy and I had to touch like the side of the belly. So the symptom doesn't mean that the implant can be found at that physical place. It can be anywhere. So I placed my hands there and I was using that. So when you have an information, you can work with that as an energy. So information was that this is an implant, let's clear it. And I sensed that the energy is running for like a few minutes and then it was clear. The next morning she sent us a text. Imagine that the swollen up arm, it's just back to normal.
Vous le voyez comment? Comme dans une vision, un flash, ou vous le sentez physiquement quand vous touchez?
Most of the time it's like information. Like if you read something and you know it, it just shows up. Sometimes it's a vision. It can show up in million ways, the information. When I bought my car, I just touched the car and I was asking, does it have any major problem? Because it was a used car and the owner didn't show up. Then I asked, okay, does it have like a minor problem that I need to know? And I had like a picture that around the front right tire, there is something around the axles or...
On peut pas vous la faire à vous, hein?
And all right, so I bought the car, took it for a checkup, and they said there is nothing major, only there is something with the right front tire and we can fix it easy, quick. So you may say it has not much to do with the acoustical vibration, right? No. The thing is, the acoustical vibration is the space of infinite possibilities. Okay. It has all the information, so you can access the information, what's required to change something or to know something. So when you have a session with someone, you can access this space, receive the information, and also you receive the tools for that to change. And there are situations when you really need to use the acoustical vibration of, let's say, a healthy organ, but actually we used it with a laptop as well. When we were in China, we had a laptop and we were using that to record the...
ordinateur portable.
We were recording this acoustical body class in China.
And we were using the laptop to record the sound. And on the first night when we went back to the hotel, the laptop... and I wanted to turn on the laptop again. And it gave an error message that fan error, so the ventilation was not working. And when it's not working, it doesn't allow you to turn on because that the chip can overheat. So I tried all the usual things like shaking.
La méthode dure.
Hit a couple of times, shake. Like, you know, take off the battery, put back the battery. I had like 10 times the same error message, nothing's changed. And you know, you have that belief, I go to sleep and next morning everything will be fine.
But it's not.
It didn't work. And then we realized like, oh, we can use the acoustical vibration for non-living things.
Alors comment vous avez fait?
There is an acoustical vibration for a brand new fan or ventilation. So I placed my hands on it and I was asking for the acoustical vibration of that to download it. And, alright, the energy was running. And then we quickly jumped into the car because we had to catch the taxi to go to the venue. Yeah. And then we opened up the laptop and ta-da, it's working.
Magic.
It's still working.
At that point it was like 7 years old, now it's a 9 years old laptop. And the ventilation is still working, nothing wrong. And we had a friend, and when I mentioned this story to this friend, who is also like a facilitator of the Access Consciousness method, said that he has a laptop and the sound, the speaker started to make weird noises, like it's like when the membrane is like damaged. So a couple of days later, he called me back and said, I just placed my hands on it for like a few minutes. And he said he did the same what I said. And he said, then I turned on the laptop and since then the sound is perfect, even better than what it was. Really, we used it in many different ways and it was really miraculous what showed.
Ça me fait penser à, je sais pas si vous connaissez Grabovoi. Voilà, c'est des suites de nombres qui font aussi des effets magiques. Enfin, c'est peut-être le même principe.
In my sense, it's working with information, but I don't know too much about Grabovoi. I know that's this about the numbers.
Est-ce que les nombres ont une vibration aussi?
As I mentioned, vibration is just one form how information can show up. So, however, it's called acoustical vibration, but it's connected to the information. Body has the capacity to receive information and to respond to information. It's not just the body, physical object.
Comment vous l'expliquez ça? Est-ce que c'est parce que on est entouré d'informations? 99,99% de la matière, c'est de l'information?
You are the creator of this reality. This reality is the playground for you. And you have the capacity to give information, and through the information you give instructions, and you can sort of communicate with the molecules, receiving the information, what's required for this to change.
Comme vous dites, on est dans un terrain de jeu, où on crée notre réalité. Quel est le but de la vie?
Have fun.
Génial.
Enjoy. Have fun and enjoy. That's why we are here, not for suffering.
Et ceux qui souffrent, ils n'ont pas compris?
What do they choose? Do they choose to have ease and joy?
Est-ce qu'ils choisissent avant leur incarnation?
We choose in each and every moment of life.
Okay.
You express your choice through fear, not just through joy. And in this reality, they teach you the limitations of this reality, and that is maintaining this reality. One of the amazing things that if you have an information, those people who are sort of like closer to you, who are willing to receive from you, because you have that information, they start to have access to that information. And through you, their reality starts to expand.
Tout le monde est relié.
Question is that about, are they willing to receive from you? Here is an example about receiving. One day, like last... nearly 2 years ago, my mother called over the phone, and my father jumped on the phone and he said in the phone, your mother has cancer, and help her. And my mom becomes so angry of him, she hang up the phone.
She didn't want to tell.
Because in her reality, she likes me so much, she doesn't want to put a burden on me. What can I do now? Can she receive from me? Not in this situation.
Faut que la personne soit apte à recevoir l'information, veuille recevoir l'information.
A few days later, I had the information that my father can receive from me and my mother can receive from my father.
Ah, okay.
All right. But my father doesn't believe in these things. So it's not about that I start to talk about and then he will do what I tell him to do. But like interchanging information doesn't have to be verbal. You as an infinite being, you can be a contribution to someone. Whoa. And it has no shape and form. Like not like I have to pray or I have to do a ceremony. It's a choice. Choice of I'm not holding back anything that I am, I'm willing to be the contribution, wholeheartedly.
Mais les miracles qui arrivent par la prière, c'est un petit peu le même principe, parce que les personnes y mettent une intention très très forte et y croient très très fortement.
So there are elements that if people get that, then they have the capacity to create miracles. Like having no points of view of the outcome, no expectations. Because if you have a point of view, it limits the possibilities. Like if I was praying for my mom to become healthy, so I'm so lucky I had no sense of urge or I have to do this. When you can function from the space of infinite possibilities, suddenly emotions disappear, and instead of that you rather have information. And it's a space where you just be. So you have access to the information, you know what to do. It becomes simple. 2 days later, they called me. We've been to the doctor again, and they did a checkup, and they found nothing.
Le papa avait bien travaillé.
Like he did. He said, Rocco, you did this. I have a different point of view. But...
Comment vous l'enseignez ça? Vous donnez confiance aux personnes à qui veulent apprendre?
So, as I mentioned, lots of information started to show up for this whole topic, how it works. And we put together this information. So we have a class that takes 2.5 days. And during the class, we have lots of exercises. So people can experience themselves.
Sur eux-mêmes?
On their body. They also practice during the class on each other. So they can see it works on them. They can see they can create this change with someone else. And also we give homework. So we really... giving this information from many angles, and obviously people can receive easier from her, sometimes from me,
sometimes from both of us, because we are a couple.
So we facilitate this training together.
Est-ce que ça marche à tous les coups à partir du moment où toutes les personnes veulent donner, veulent recevoir?
That's the key thing, if they are willing to receive.
C'est ça le plus dur, donc à persuader les gens que s'ils reçoivent.
One of the beauty of this whole thing is that what I mentioned that you have, I as a facilitator, I have this information, and during the class people connected to me, connected to us.
Yes.
And they start to have access to that level of information, so I don't have to convince them.
D'accord.
Because during the class they have their own experience as well. So they can see, I'm not the only one who can do this.
That's what we would like to share with them. Everyone is possible. Everyone can do it. It's not a special thing, really. Everyone can do it. They can use it in their life, in their body, create huge changes.
Ils ont les mêmes expériences que vous. Ils voient la même chose, ils ressentent les mêmes choses. Ou chacun a une expérience différente.
Everyone is different, so...
So they may have a different sense, but they can do the same thing. Like how they sense the energy can be different than how I sense, but it's personal. But the rest is the same.
Écoutez, ça a l'air magique. Vous en avez très très bien parlé. Si vous voulez rajouter quelque chose...
People have infinite possibilities. What would it take for them to start to function from that?
What would it take to, realize they have choice? They can choose a totally different reality. Because they can create a totally different reality.
C'est très optimiste, mais c'est la réalité.
Choice.
We see that those people who attend the class and they choose, their reality changes.
We have really great feedbacks actually from the people, not just the physical healings, but the whole life change. It's amazing to see that.
Mais ça, j'en suis convaincu. Je l'étais convaincu avant. Vous avez fait une confirmation.
Merci beaucoup.
Merci beaucoup. Juste une dernière question. Vous êtes en Corse pour quelques jours. Comment vous trouvez la Corse et les Corses?
The island is beautiful and amazing, really.
And we have a beautiful view in our from and our apartment. Really, we see the sea.
People living in a beautiful place.
Beautiful island.
That's already it's a choice.
C'est mon choix en tout cas. Merci beaucoup.
Merci beaucoup.
Merci beaucoup.
Thank you.